Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Anaconda on a Windows operating system. So I'm going to show you the 2023 edition of Anaconda in this video. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, you can always put a comment in our comment sections. I'm always there to help you. And if you really like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends so that I am really get motivated to make more such videos. And also please don't forget to subscribe our channel. So let's begin. Now to install Anaconda, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply search with Anaconda download and hit enter, and this will show you this www.anaconda.com as our first search result. So here just simply click on this link, and this is going to redirect to the official site of Anaconda, and here you can see it is available for Windows, macOS and Linux. So for Windows, you need to just simply click on this download button, and it's going to start downloading our Anaconda, the version 2023.1. Okay, so here you can see I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply cancel it. I'll minimize my browser, I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see the Anaconda 2023.03 version is already been downloaded over here. So just simply double click on the installer, and you can see the file size is 786 MB, so that much amount of bandwidth you'll need to download Anaconda. Alright, so you can minimize your download directory, and you can see our Anaconda installation wizard is rightly open. So just simply click on next. And this is our, you know, license agreement. You can always read this and just simply click on I agree. And here under this select installation type, it is asking what type of installation you'd want. So just me or for all users. So I'm going to choose just me and just simply click on next. And this is where our Anaconda is going to be installed. That is, they're going to create this Anaconda 3 folder. And here you can see we need 4.7 gigabyte of free space on our C drive. Okay, so currently my available size is 43.6 GB, so which is sufficient. Okay, so all other things are fine. Just simply click on next, and here under advanced installation options, they have, you know, given some check boxes. I'll be recommending you to keep this default and just simply click on install, and it will going to start installing our Anaconda. Okay, you can always click on the show details to see what are all they are doing. So they are currently extracting several packages and then they installing it on our system. So this will take some time, a couple of minutes. After that, I am again going to coming back to this video. Yep. So welcome back. And now as you can see that our Anaconda is rightly installed, but the thing is it took nearly half an hour. Okay, so the thing is for your time also when you'll be installing, if you see it's taking a lot of time, I think it's totally normal. Okay, so finally you'll be able to see like it's completed. So now you can just simply click on next, and here you can see everything you love about Anaconda is now available from the cloud. So fine, just simply click on next. Welcome to Anaconda and get started with the Anaconda distribution. So just simply click on finish, and it automatically going to redirect to the browser. You can minimize this. So now that our Anaconda is rightly installed, you can just simply click on the search icon and just simply search over here Anaconda. Okay, and you'll be seeing this Anaconda Navigator over here. So just simply open that Anaconda Navigator. And you can see our Anaconda Navigator is rightly started launching. And you can see that our Anaconda Navigator is rightly launched. So it's currently loading some packages. So let's give a couple of minutes. So you can see our Anaconda Navigator is now properly launched. So here you will see different type of applications. So we have this Jupyter Lab, then Jupyter Notebook, PowerShell, Qt Console, and several things like Spyder also we have. So if you want to install any of the product, like let's say you want to install Art Studio, Then you need to click on this install button, and it's going to, you know, fetch all the files, and it automatically going to install on your system. So then again, you, from our Anaconda Navigator, you can launch all these different type of applications. Okay, I'm going to show you about these two product, that is this Jupyter Notebook and Spyder, in this video. So first I'm going to click on this launch button. So if you see these two, Spyder and Jupyter are already been installed, so it comes along with Anaconda. So let's invoke our Jupyter Notebook, and it's going to redirect to the browser. And here you can see on our local host, our Jupyter Notebook is rightly opened over here. So here you can just simply click on this new, then Python 3 kernel, and it's going to open a new tab with our new Python 3 shell. And here, if you see, we have this Jupyter Notebook. So let's, you know, type a simple hello world code in Python. So print hello world, and if you just simply click on this run button, it's going to show you the output hello world. So if you want to add a couple of number like 5 plus 2, hit enter, you can see that output 7 rightly shown. Okay, so we use mainly Jupyter Notebook for you know, doing the machine learning stuff. So if you are into machine learning, you can always use Jupyter Notebook. Okay, and now if I go back to the Anaconda, here you can see we have Spyder as well here, right? So if you just simply click on this launch button, it's going to launch our Spyder. And you can see that our latest version of Spyder, which is Spyder version 5, is rightly started launching. And you can see our Spyder is rightly launched. So they are currently loading the interfaces. And this is our interface of Spyder. Okay, and here you can see in temp.py means our Python file. So they have given a sample hello world program along with a simple mathematical operation of summation 5 plus 2. Okay, so if you just simply want to run that, just simply click on this run button, and it's going to start connecting to our kernel, and after that it's going to show you the output. And here you can see the output hello world is rightly shown. So this is actually multiplication a into b, so that is what you are getting here, 5 into 2. Okay, so in this way you can easily invoke Spyder from our Anaconda Navigator. I have also shown you about how you can invoke our Jupyter Notebook. Similarly, if you want to install RStudio, I have already mentioned you can install it from this install button. Okay, so all these applications, like whichever is showing this launch button, are actually comes with Anaconda itself. And this special software like Data Spill and all, or Visual Studio also comes, you can see. So if you want to install Data Spill or RStudio or Orange 3, so for that you need to just simply click on this install button. Okay, so in this way you can easily install latest version of Anaconda Navigator on your Windows operating system. If you face any issues in middle on how to install Anaconda, you can always put a comment in our comment sections. I'm always there to help you. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.